Welcome to the MLTI Family Information Night for Pemetic Elementary School. I have three goals with this presentation. First, to help you understand the expectations around using the school devices. Second, to share some tips to guardians on home usage of these devices. And third, to help both students and families get on the same page about technology use. The district created a new intervention rubric for students who are not meeting expectations in 2022. I will not go over all of this rubric, but the link for this document can be found on the Pemetic website on the Family Portal. It is the Technology RTI rubric. The rubric has three levels of violations and interventions to help the student get back on track with their technology use. Level 3 offenses are the most severe offenses, such as vandalism, and will immediately involve a family meeting. The following are care and usage guidelines for the students at school and at home. 1. Any device with video recording capabilities are not allowed in locker rooms and bathrooms, including phones. 2. Devices must come to school fully charged. I recommend to students that they put their backpacks wherever they are charging their laptops, and that the location be safe from pets and other damage. 3. Protect the device from weather and extreme heat or cold. 4. Devices are educational tools, not game devices. 5. Keep passwords private, but teachers, admin, and guardians have access if they request it. 6. Any damage needs to be reported immediately. 7. The acceptable use policy is in effect at all times, even when outside of school. 8. Keep food and drink away from the devices. Crumbs are horrible, but liquids will completely destroy the device. 9. The cost of repairs from intentional abuse are completely the responsibility of the family. And 10. Keep the device in secure locations, not left on a bench or unlocked car. Now, screen care is important. A screen replacement costs just under $300 and means a week or maybe even more without the device. They must be zipped when they're being transported into their case. Pressure of any type on the lid can break the screen. Do not use any chemicals, please, to clean the screens. If you need to, you can use a soft cotton cloth and dampen one corner with a little water to clean it off. Then use the dry part of the cloth to scrub off the haze that is left. Never put anything on your keyboard. No pens, pencils, or even keyboard covers. The gap of the screen to the keyboard is very tight, and the screen will crack when you shut it. Guardians are responsible for students using devices safely at home. I recommend that 1. The guardians collect all the devices at home. Students do not need access to them 24/7. I also highly recommend that devices are used under supervision. Students should be in public spaces in the home while working on their device. Check in with them. See what they're working on. These devices have no filtering when they're off the school network. Students have access to anything on the internet at home. And finally, we're working on learning and forming some help resources for families to address the addictive nature of YouTube, social media, games, and other things. If you're interested in that, my email's at the end of this presentation, and you can send me an email to be included when that group gets going. And now for some details about the district acceptable use policy. This and all other policies are available from the district website. Access to school devices is a privilege and not a right. The principal has the full right to remove a student's access to school technology devices. Students must follow the acceptable use policy and any classroom rules or instructions of the supervising staff. Students have no privacy on their devices. All emails, documents, web history, etc. is available for viewing if needed. Families are responsible for up to $100 of accidental damage to the device. For lost or damaged chargers, the fee is $50. Lost or damaged earbuds must be replaced, or there is a $5 fee. And finally, if the computer is intentionally damaged, families are responsible for the complete cost of repair. Please pause the video and put this information somewhere safe. If you need help with the laptop or Apple software such as Pages or Keynote, students and families can call this phone number for help. Just enter 46584 when it asks for your PIN number. This is open 24 hours a day. In order for students to take their laptops home, the following four things have to happen. First, they need to watch this video with their guardian or guardians. A guardian needs to log into PowerSchool and complete both the permissions agreements and home internet access survey forms. The student needs to pass their laptop quiz, and the student needs to be caring for the laptop properly. Finally, here is my email as promised. If you have any questions or you're interested in participating in the technology dependence workshops when we get those set up, please email me. That's all, and have a great school year.